وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. We were mentioning some scholars who took from female scholars. Inshallah ta'ala, in this episode, I'm going to carry on from some, naming some of those scholars and those great imams of Islam who took from female scholars. I'm going to mention, inshallah ta'ala, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, who died the year 728 Hijriah. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he took from Ummul Arab, Fatima binti Abi al-Qasim ibn Asakir. He took from Ummul Arab, Fatima binti Abi al-Qasim ibn Asakir. He narrated from her hadith. He took from her. She is the daughter of Ibn Asakir. He also took from Ummu Ahmad, Zainab binti Makki ibn Ali ibn Kamil al-Harraniyah. This woman, Ummu Ahmad, was mentioned, يَزْدَحِمُ الطَّالَبَةُ عَلَيْهَا, the female scholars, the female students of knowledge, and the male students of knowledge, they would crowd her circles to take knowledge from her because of her knowledge and her piety. يعني, she narrated the musnad of Imam Ahmad in its entirety, all of it. So he took from her hadith, Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, Ummu Muhammad, Zainab, binti Ahmad ibn Umar ibn Kamil. Ibn Taymiyyah traveled for her. تفردت وارتحلت إليها الطلبة. Students traveled from all over the world to seek knowledge from her. And Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he traveled to seek knowledge from her. And he took from her in Egypt. And she also used to narrate in Al-Madinah al-Munawwarah, the Prophet city, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ibn Taymiyyah also had female scholars. From his most prominent female scholars is Fatima bint Abbas ibn Abi al-Fath Muhammad ibn Muhammad al-Baghdadiyya. She was min al-alimat al-fadilat, one of the senior students of Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, and a virtuous woman. It was said about her, ta'muru bil-ma'roof, she used to call to the good and prohibit the evil. And she also had a strong يعني, refutations against a deviated group known as Ahmadiyya. She refuted them, and she mentioned their mistakes and their shortcomings. She used to do, as Ibn Kathir rahimahullah mentions, وتفعل من ذلك ما لا يقدر عليه الرجال. She used to do things that even the men would not be able to do. The energy and the enthusiasm that she had for knowledge. And Ibn Taymiyyah, he praised her and he referred to her as a virtuous, bona fide scholar. And he mentioned from her, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, that she also, Ibn Taymiyyah saying this, أنها كانت تحتضر كثيرا من المغني أو أكثر. Rather, she memorized Al-Mughni ibn Qudama rahimahullah. And you know Al-Mughni ibn Qudama, with the tahqiq of Sheikh Abdullah Turki right now, it's 15 volumes. With the taba'a, the best taba'a so far out now, is the taba'a of Sheikh Abdullah Turki. It's 15 volumes. She memorized its entirety, it was said. وَلِذَلِكَ وَأَنَّوْ كَانَ يَسْتَعِدُّ لَهَا مِنْ كَثْرَةِ مَسَائِلِهَا وحسن سؤالاتها وسرعة فهمها. ولذلك ابن تيمية was mentioned, he would يعني take some things from her because of her يعني memory of the kitab of Ibn Qudama and how subhanAllah she was solid in her questions. She had very good questions to ask and she was fast in understanding things. That's the type of person she was. Also Al-Hafidh Al-Mundhiri rahimahullah, who died in 606, he did not only narrate from the shuyukh, the male scholars, بَلْ تَعَدَّاهُمْ, rather he went on forward to seeking knowledge and taking knowledge مِنَ الشَّيْخَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ, from the female scholars who were out there. And he had narrated from a large quantity of them. I'm going to mention some of them, inshallah ta'ala. In Egypt, in Qahira, he narrated from Safa'ul Aish, بنت عبد الله الأشرفية. He narrated from her. He took knowledge from her. Also, he took from Hassan, Ghadiba, Binti Adnan, Binti Ananin, Ibn Humaydin al-Sa'diyah, who died in the year 635 Hijriya. He took from Al-Shaykhatu al-Saliha, al-Fadl, Karima Binti Abdul Haq, Ibn Hibati Allahi, Ibn Dhafir Ibn Hamza al-Qudaiya, Al-Shafi'iyah, he took from her, who died in the year 641 Hijriya. He also took from al-Khayr, Futuh Binti Ibrahim Ibn Uthman, Ibn Abi al-Qasim al-Shamiyyah al-Masri. He took from her as well, who died in the year 625 Hijriya. And he took from many other. From the women he took from in Damascus was Sittatu al-Katabati, Bintu Ali ibn Yahya ibn Muhammad ibn Ali ibn Tarrah al-Baghdadiyu al-Mudiru. He took from her, who died in 604 Hijriya. He also took from Ash-Shaykhatu al-Musnada, and the narrations that she had was large in quantity. Al-Fadl Karimah, Bint Abdul Wahhab ibn Ali ibn Khadr, Ibn Ali ibn Ali, Ibn Abdullah ibn Ali, Al-Qurashiyyah al-Asadiyyah al-Zubayriyyah al-Dimashqiyyah, who died in 641 Hijriya. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi said about her, As-Salihah al-Mu'ammaratu Musnadatu al-Sham. And she was the Musnadah of Sham, where people would come to take all of the narrations from her. Al-Imam al-Mundhiri said about her, وَحَدَّثَتْ بِالْكَثِيرِ, she narrated for a very long time. وَقِيلَ أَنَّهَا حَدَّثَتْ نَيِّفًا وَسِتِينَ سَنَةً. It was mentioned that 60 something years she was teaching. And he met her in Dimashq and he took from her. Also, Abdul Karim, Fatima, who was the daughter of Sheikh Abi Al Hassan, Sa'ad Al Khair, Muhammad ibn Sahri ibn Sa'ad al Ansari al Andalusi. She took from him. He took from her the year when it was 600 Hijriya. And Imam al Mundhiri, he said about her, وحدثت بدمشق والقاهرة بالكثير سمع منها جماعة من شيوخنا ورفقائنا ولنا منها إجازة. And he praised her a lot, and that he mentioned that she spread knowledge, رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. One of the scholars that I'm going to mention, inshallah ta'ala, is Imam al-Dhahabi, رحمه الله تعالى. Imam al-Dhahabi, he narrated from many female scholars. وكان نهما لا سيما في علم الرواية الحديث. Imam al-Dhahabi, as it's known, يعني he was a person who loved knowledge and was hungry for knowledge and was deeply rooted in the science of knowledge. And he took from many women, but I'm not going to mention all of them. I'm only going to mention one specific woman in which Al-Imam al-Dhahabi regretted. كَانَ يَتَحَسَّرُ عَلَى عَدَمِ لِقَائِهَا. He used to become very sad whenever he would remember that he never met her and that he never took from her. He would be sad about it. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi. And that's none other than Muhammad. سيدة بنت موسى بن عثمان المارانية المصرية who died in 695 Hijriya. He said about himself, وَقَدْ رَحَلْتُ إِلَى لِقَائِهَا. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, he said, I traveled, I cut distance to narrate from her. فَمَاتَتْ وَأَنَا بِفِلِسْطِينَ. And Al-Imam al-Dhahabi said, I was on it, because he was going to Qahira in order to meet her, Egypt. But then he was in Philistine, and he said, when the month was Rajab, sanata 95 wa 600, she passed away, she died. And he used to say, rahimahullah, Imam al-Dhahabi, kuntu atalahafu ala liqa'iha wa rahaltu ila Misra wa ilmi annaha baqiyatun. He said, I went to Egypt and I thought she was still alive. Fadakhaltu fawajadtuha, I found, qad matat min asharati ayyamin. I just found that she died 10 days before I came. توفيت يوم الجمعة سادس رجب وأنا بوادي فحمة. And that woman, if there's no honor, any other honor for her, the fact that Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله came and traveled just to take knowledge from her, wallahi shows a lot. And Imam al-Dhahabi is a great imam. That shows you what type of woman she was, what type of knowledge that she possessed. Allah raised her subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is enough honor for her. One of the most honorable women, wallahi, that I think is worthy of mentioning her is Sittatu al-Ahl, Binti Uthman. She took ijaza min Abi al-Yasr and Jamaluddin ibn Malik and Zuhair ibn Umar al-Zura'i and Jama'atul Akharin. Dhahabi narrated from her And he mentioned clearly, I have taken from her. He was very happy to have taken from her. Inshallah ta'ala, we're going to be speaking about these issues in more details bi-idhnillah al-kareem. Another great scholar is Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. Ibn Rajab mentions it, and Dawudi mentioned it, that Ibn al-Qayyim heard from Fatima binti Muhammad ibn al-Shaykh, Ibrahim ibn Mahmud ibn Jawhar al-Tabahi, al-Batahiyu, sorry. She's a muhaditha. She narrated Sahih al-Bukhari and Ibn al-Zubaydi many times. She heard Sahih Muslim many times. From them she heard from al-Husayriyu, Shaykh al-Hanafiyya of her time. He said about al-Imam al-Dhahabi, or al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim, sorry. He said, كانت دينا. She was a righteous woman. متعبدة, صالحة. مسندة, يعني a righteous woman. A worshipper of Allah, تبارك وتعالى, a pious individual. And she died when the year was Sanata 86. That's when she passed away. She died in the month of Safar. One of the great scholars, al-Imam ibn al-Hajjar al-Asqalani, خاتمة أمراء المؤمنين في الحديث, حافظ ابن حجر. Al-Imam al-Sakhawi has a tarjama on his own sheikh. Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi wrote a book about his teacher Hafidh ibn Hajar, where he speaks about who Ibn Hajar was and his life. And he categorized the names of the teachers of Ibn Hajar into three categories. Sakhawi, Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi. And he mentioned the first ones are في من سمع منه الحديث وذكر من بينهم عشرين امرأة. So he mentions those which he heard hadith from. And in there he mentioned 20 women that Ibn Hajar heard from. The second category he said is those who gave him ijaza. فِيمَنْ أَجَازَ لَهُ, they gave him ijaza, which is considered from his shuyukhs. And he mentioned that ثَلَاثًا وَثَلَاثِينَ مَرَاهُ, 33 women gave ijaza to Ibn Hajar. And the third category is فِيمَنْ أَخَذَ عَنْهُ مُذَاكَرَةً أَوْ إِنْشَاءً, those in which he took from them from revision and etc. And here, only person who here was Sittatu Rakb, Ibnatu Ali ibn Hajar, who is the sister of Hafidh ibn Hajar, his own sister. And these great scholars that we're talking about, Imam al-Zahabi, Ibn al-Qayyim, Ibn al-Taymiyyah, Ibn al-Hajar, yani these great scholars of Islam took from these women. I want to mention the conclusion of this particular point, inshallah ta'ala. Mafkharatu lirrawiyat, an honor for the women who narrate, the knowledge, an honor for female women, which is lying. I've mentioned this before, but I'm going to repeat it again. Lying has happened in ilm al-hadith. There were men who came and they lied about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they attributed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that which he never said or did. As for the women, even though they were large in number, there was not any woman who was ever mentioned that she lied about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Never. And the reason to that is because what it seems like is this jur'ah, this hard-headed stubbornness that females have in saying things, it wasn't present in the women. And I wasn't the one who said this, brothers and sisters. It is Imam al-Jarh wa al-Ta'dil, fi asrihi al-Hafidh al-Naqid, al-Imam al-Jihbid, Shamsuddin al-Dhahabi, who said this. He mentions this in his kitab Mizan al-I'tidal fi naqdi al-rijal. He said, "Wa ma 'alimtu fi an-nisa'i man ittuhimat wa la man tarakuha." He said, "I don't know any woman who was suspected, ittuhimat yani bil kadhib, who lied, who was suspected of lying." Imagine that. And no woman I know who has abandoned her narration because of that. And this, wallahi, it's something praiseworthy, something to be very happy about. That the women have become known bi sidqi wa dini wa al-adalati wa al-amanati fi al-ilmi wa al-riwaya. That the women were known for truthfulness, religion, piety, justice, and trustworthiness in knowledge and narrations. And that is enough, wallahi, for the women. Wa hasbuhunna dhalika fakhra. That is enough for you, honor sisters. This point, if we go into it more details, we're going to يعني find even more females, scholars, and that's enough for inshallah ta'ala to understand the female scholars who passed on knowledge. Inshallah ta'ala, I've got more other points to discuss in the upcoming episodes. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdi, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.